Yeah, let us work out over some over here. The array of light passes from a glass refractive index 1.52 to water refractive index 1.33. What is the critical angle of incidence? I have to calculate my critical angle of incidence. To calculate the critical angle of incidence, I should know some of the basic concepts over here. To start with, I am giving a solution for you to find out the critical angle of incidence. You should know the primary basic essential thing. When a ray passes from one medium to another, the ray gets refracted, which means, let us consider this is a rarer medium and this is a denser medium. When a ray passes from one medium to another, it bends, when denser to rarer, it bends away from the normal. So this is a refracted ray and this is your incident ray. Now, what is the critical angle of incidence? Suppose if the ray which is traveling from one medium to another, alright, if it makes an angle of 90 degree, for example, if there is an increase in the angle of incidence, what happens to a refracted ray? This refracted ray, due to increase in the angle of incidence, it moves towards this x-axis. So then what happens? This ray falls on this x-axis and travels along the x-axis. Now the angle between the normal to the refracted ray is your angle of 90 degree, which is equal to r. So now the angle which is at this point of incidence, you call this angle as critical angle, which means your angle of incidence is equal to a critical angle of incidence when at point where your refracted angle is equal to 90 degree, right? So this you can do with your refractive formula, that is mu 1 of sine I is equal to mu 2 of sine R, that is angle of incidence sine IC. Here they are given, that is, this is your rarer and denser, because it bends away from the normal. Denser medium, which means your refractive index is higher compared to water, your glass is refractive index mu G, this is equal to 1.52, and here the refractive index mu of W, this is equal to 1.33, right? Now, and there are the conditions are given here, right? Mu of I sine IC, mu 2 sine R. Now I can write, instead of mu 1, that is mu of G sine IC, this is equal to mu of W sine of R. So sine IC divided by sine R, this is equal to mu W divided by mu of G. So the varying conditions here, I is equal to IC, and that is suffix I of C, and R is equal to 90 degree, and mu W is given the value and mu G is given the value. I am rewriting it the formula which is above. Sine IC is by sine of R, which is sine 90, this is equal to mu W 1.33 divided by 1.52. So I have to calculate my angle of incidence, critical angle of incidence, that is sine IC. So sine 90 becomes 1, which is equal to 1.33 divided by 1.52. So 1.33 divided by 1.52, that is 133 divided by 152. So I have to go for my basic division, 152 divided by 133. So it is smaller, I am adding a bit 0. So approximately, so let us try out with 7 times 152, that is 1434, 36, 1064. So let us go for another 152, and 152, 8 to 16, 40, 41, 1, 8 until 11, 12, 1, 2, 1, 6. So if we go for another 152, it becomes, alright, 366, but here there is only 330. So I can go 8 times of 152 is 1216, and if you keep on this 4, 1, 1 and 0, so it is 1064, again here 11, so you will get approximately 8 times, right, for this 7 times. So this is 0.87, right? So my sine IC, this is equal to 0.87. Then what is my IC? IC is equal to sine inverse of 0.87. But if you see in examination options, your values will be given, that angles will be given. So to determine the angle, right? So I have some basic concepts I should know well prior to the examinations regarding sine values, the known values of sine. For example, if I take sine root 3 by 2, that is 1.732 divided by 2, it gives 0.86, right? So then root 3 by 2 is nothing but my sine, this is root 3 by 2 is equal to 60 degree, all right? Sine 60 degree is my root 3 by 2, and sine inverse of 0.87, I can say approximately, looking at the values given in my options, if there are values nearer to 60 plus, I can write down angle of incidence IC is equal, or sorry, approximately it is 60 degree. So dear viewers, you just see what is the sum asked and how to plug in the values. So you can, if you know the concepts well, you can immediately at the first step at approaching this sum, you can write down mu of g at this step, mu of g into sine of IC equal to mu of w into sine r, and you can proceed up. But to your information, I am just giving in some of the inputs how you can work out when you are in need of to find the critical angle of incidence. Right? Keep watching for the next sum.